Archie's Madhouse, Issue 36. Some guys want to take Sabrina to the dance tonight. She thinks there's no reason why she can't help Bob. Not only is she forgetting she's not allowed to date, but she's forgetting she's not allowed to do good either, somehow. She uses magic so that someone will curve like he's never curved before. He gets a strike two lanes over. How did this happen by accident? She would have imagined him getting a strike. Is this whole story going to be her being impossibly incompetent? That's not funny. She wants the ball to stick to the lane this time, and even thinks the word stick multiple times. Gee, I wonder if something will go wrong. So the bowling ball sticks to his hand, and he ends up getting sent into the pins. People would know this was magic. It would actually be less frustrating if she was doing this on purpose instead of her being impossibly stupid. Because at least then it would be competent of her. She wouldn't imagine this either. It makes sense that she isn't giving up on using magic to help them because of the sunken cost fallacy. She thinks Mike is the better bowler, and therefore the one she'd like to go dancing with. So she puts some confidence potion in his soda. Let me guess, this won't help him either. He feels like beating his bully. It's bullshit that he just says that someone's tickling him when he gets punched. That should never be written. So he punches them into the pins. There's depressing realistic consequences because he has to get carried away on a stretcher. Sure is inconvenient for Sabrina that she never thinks to reverse time. She could at least heal him and erase people's memories of the fact that he got hurt. And Sabrina at least gets punished for meddling and trying to cheat with magic for them because she has to date the ugliest guy. But at least she's optimistic enough to think that she can't complain about having to date George because he's a good dancer. Oh, but that's not the end of the story, actually. So I guess she won't even get to date him. He says if he bowls well, he'll treat her to all the pizza he can eat. He wouldn't say this. He would have done that anyways if he liked her so much. He bowls one strike after another because of Sabrina's magic. So why wasn't she getting this right all along? I guess Sabrina would feel weird about dating a guy she conjured up. He wouldn't really have free will, I guess. Someone runs up to Sabrina in excitement and is told that he bowled a perfect 300 game. He then faints because bullshit, so now she has no one to go dancing with. Then a guy with black hair greets her while also knowing her name. Is this the first appearance of Harvey? No, it's Sam the football captain. His hairstyle is slightly different, but for all I know, this was early installment weirdness. He says he's been looking everywhere for her to ask her out. She says she's bowled over, but her magic causes the bowling ball to crash into her. At least that kind of makes sense because she would have imagined that, but she didn't point. And magic would be far more dangerous if it could be triggered just by saying idioms and phrases. So she's injured and can't even dance with him. She would have just healed herself. This is a sadistic, horrible story. It ends with her in the hospital with a broken leg. At least Salem is being nice to her. But why establish that he's her familiar that she needs for magic just to never have him around her? I guess as long as he's in the same city, it's fine. Or they dropped that lore. This story was about Sabrina somehow being incompetent with her magic over and over again. Some guys wanted to ask her out, and she made them fail, somehow. And she made the ugly guy that she somehow wanted to dance with because he's a good dancer do great, but he did so great that he fainted. And then she got hurt. You'd think she would have just healed herself. She didn't do anything to deserve all this, and she's too stupid to be believable.